talking a little bit this week, and I promised them that we were going to talk about the workshop model. You know, there's these three different elements now of CAR that you know, what my son had, where we live close enough that we had the whole team come in and we had regular clinics, and there's the workshop model, and of course now people have the benefit of CAR e-learning and skills. But, and I feel like we talk about my son's experience and other people's experience with having, you know, CARD be close by and having that whole team of people in, and we talk about the CARD e-learning experience and using skills, and we haven't spent enough time talking about the workshop model. Sure. And it's really amazing, and it gives people opportunities in far-flung reaches of the globe. So tell us a little bit about how the workshop model came about and some of the things that families experience on the workshop model.
I think, you know, workshops have always been in existence. Mm-hmm. I mean, even when I started at CARD, we were already providing workshops.
Really?
And, you know, in essence, workshops, you know, fundamentally are the starting point for new offices. Mm. So when I first came in, we were providing services to different parts of the states. Mm-hmm. And so we had supervisors in different areas, and we were providing training out there in different parts, Virginia and New York and so forth. Mm-hmm. And that's what brought about new sites.
Interesting.
And so, you know, fundamentally, it's a source for expansion.
Right, right.
Know? And we had the ability to send supervisors out and provide training and to families and their teams. And it's really just an opportunity for us to work with families that we just aren't able to reach on a typical day.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I always compare it to the super nanny.
Yeah.
Is that pretty accurate? But I say to people, you know how the super nanny comes to your house and assesses what's going on, and they come up with a plan, and they train the parents, they train the kids, and then she leaves.
Well, it's in the beginning it is. There's a period of assessment. There's definitely working with the parents directly, working with the team that they're working, that they've hired. Mm-hmm. There's also an aspect of working directly with the child and the school system, if there's aides and so forth. But we don't want to just leave them. You know,
right.
We want to be able to give families the opportunity to receive ongoing supervision from us. And so after that initial training and assessment period, then you are looking at an ongoing supervision program.
And how does that happen? How often is it different in each case when the supervisor comes back?
For the most part, every family will have a rotation of visits and non-visits. Mm-hmm. And every month there's going to be a certain set of number of hours that a family is receiving as far as supervision goes.
Okay.
So initially, you're looking at a minimum of 2 to 2 days, mm-hmm. which encompasses training, mm-hmm. assessment, as well as observation time.
Okay.
And then every month thereafter, or after the supervisor comes back to their home base, then families are in communication with their supervisors, probably on average about, I want to say bare minimum, 2 hours a month, but typically it's around 4 to 6 hours per month.
Okay.
For those families that are familiar with how we work locally, it's very similar to clinics.
Okay.
Except, you know, because we're in different locations, they're done by phone or they're done video conferencing or some other means of communication.
Awesome.
And then every 3 to 4 months, the supervisor will go back into the home setting.
Okay.
And then provide training again for the staff if that's needed. Modify the program as needed, as well as do observations, work with the parents, and so forth.
And what I love about it is it's so super smart, you know, because we can't all live within 30 to 50 miles of a CARD location. But to have the benefit of that, I think the big difference, besides the distance, is that in the cases of workshop model, you are gathering your own team. CARD doesn't do it for you.
Correct.
And I think for a lot of people that can feel like it's overwhelming and intimidating, but CARD e-learning is an awesome tool to be able to help you to do that, and to keep in mind that the supervisor comes and helps to train that team.
And really, I think one of the questions families ask me is how is the quality of the supervision differ if I have a workshop family versus a local family? And the supervisor is just as accessible regardless of where you are. The only difference, or the only thing that we have to consider, is time difference.
Right.
And how we go about communicating with families. And so a supervisor here may may not be able to just get in their car and do a school observation within the week.
Right.
A supervisor here may not be able to attend an IEP that just got scheduled.
Right.
And so it's a little bit more planning.
Yes.
But as far as the quality of the supervision, the quality of the contact, it's ultimately the same.
Awesome. Awesome. And what I'm hearing from a lot of people is that they're being very smart about doing workshop model, that if there's one family in one place who wants to do a workshop model and they want to have it be a little less expensive, that they can get together with several other families.
Yes.
And do workshop model together.
Yes.
So that the supervisor comes and can service, you know, two or five families at, mm-hmm, a time, which makes it much more effective, efficient, and less expensive.
Yes.
Which we all know that funding is a huge part of this journey.
There's a lot of advantages to sharing a supervisor in a local, in an area.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of advantages. Number one, definitely you minimize costs as far as the travel and the flight expenses, because, mm-hmm, all the families that are being seen that day are going to share those expenses.
Absolutely.
But also, when you have other families in your area that are going to conduct the same program or have a similar program, all the families can virtually share therapists.
Right, right. And that minimizes, you know, the amount of time that you're spending looking to staff,
yes,
that team.
Yes, and you automatically have a pool of resource for other therapists. And also, I think we've found that therapists who work with multiple families really gain the most experience, obviously,
yeah,
but also are more committed to staying.
Yeah. So, well, it gives you a built-in support system,
yeah,
of people who get it. We,
yeah,
talk all the time about how valuable that, mm-hmm, is to have people in your corner who get it.
Yes.
So a wonderful, wonderful thing. And there's also a new initiative here at CARD, because you guys are opening offices in new places, that if you have a group of families together,
yes,
if you have 20 families together, then you can jumpstart and go right to opening an office.
Yeah, and I don't actually think, I think we can even move forward with setting up a site somewhere around 10 families.
Really?
We really want to just make sure that families have a means of obtaining funding. So,
right,
whether it's through their insurance or their school district or other,
right,
other third-party organization,
mm-hmm,
there has to be some means for families to maintain a consistent funding source.
Okay, and let's talk a little bit about the workshop model in terms of insurance. And,
sure,
and we've talked with Bryce a little bit about this last,
right,
week, but is there any difference in terms of insurance if it's the workshop model or the basic CARD model?
No, there really isn't. Insurance companies work very similarly across the board. What they're looking for, people with a certain credentials or with a certain level of degree, certain degree.
Mm-hmm.
So I think in our cases it's a master's degree and or BCBA.
Mm-hmm.
And they, we do have families who are receiving workshops right now that have insurance funding.
Isn't that exciting?
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that Bryce was saying the other day, that there is this window of time right now because insurance companies, I just want to remind you guys, if you missed it, there's a window of time because insurance companies, even they're scrambling at this point to find providers.
Yes.
That they have this deal where if you're in provider or out provider, but if they don't have an in provider for you to choose from, then they have to pay the full price on the out provider.
Mm-hmm.
And that it's going to take between 2 and 3 years, they estimate, for them to really be up to speed with all the in providers. This is a wonderful opportunity to take advantage. Call your insurance company, call the CARD location that's closest to you. You can find that on the centerforautism.com site and see if you can get CARD as your workshop provider.
Yes.
Right now. It could be for the next 2-3 years.
Yes.
That your insurance will cover it, and it's possible that down the road they may not. But in this window of time, we know how much can be done in 2 years.
Yes.
Right?
I automatically tell every family to look into their insurance policy,
mm-hmm,
communicate with our contracts team here at CARD, and just get an idea of what is possible and what is in existence right now. And I think it's because there's so many options out there for families. I think it's just because you didn't think you had funding or it wasn't covered last year,
right,
doesn't necessarily mean it
right,
isn't covered now. And also, I think families don't always know the extent of what their policy covers.
Yeah, so I think that's absolutely the case for,
yeah,
all of us. And even for me, it's different for me today than it was,
mm-hmm,
3 months ago. And it's going to be different again in July. And,
yeah,
and you know, we shared with Bryce the other day that it's not easy to find out, but we have to keep on,
yes,
plugging.
And I tell families, it's worth the effort to double check.
Yeah.
It is definitely worth the effort. Even if you think you know your policy hands down and everyone has said no to you, double check it and make them confirm it with you.
I believe in that whole thing about never take a no from somebody who wasn't authorized to give you a yes.
Yes.
Go higher.
I always ask for paperwork.
That's right. Show me it in writing. Okay. And we, of course, always encourage you to start looking at www.autismvotes.org because it's going to tell you what the current insurance laws are. It's a great place to start. And then talk to your HR director.